Hey, so taxonomy is a totally complicated, really interesting field of science responsible for the naming and classification of things. And we started to kind of get into this topic with our previous episode on what is a species, where we look into species definitions and concepts. But I thought it would be really fun to do a hands-on experiment. And there's nothing better than getting a couple of expert taxonomists in on the game.
I'm Olivier Rieppel. I'm the Rowe Family Curator of Evolutionary Biology here at the Field Museum in Chicago.
I'm Janet Voight. I'm a MacArthur Associate Curator here at the Field Museum, an integrative research center.
My name is Larry Heaney. I am the Nagani Curator of Mammals at the Field Museum of Natural History.
My name is Margaret Thayer. I'm a Curator Emeritus at the Field Museum. I study insects, particularly beetles.
And we wanted to get them to look at something in depth that maybe they hadn't considered classifying before. Skittles. Peanut M&Ms. Peanut butter M&Ms. Nerds. Plain M&Ms. Starbursts. Reese's Pieces. Jelly beans. Chocolate covered peanuts. Chewy Jolly Rancher thingies. Starburst jelly beans. And we had some black licorice, but I lost it. That's right, we're doing the taxonomy of candy.
If you want to classify things, and that can be anything, I mean, organisms you classify according to evolutionary relationships. With candy or office furniture or whatever, you classify according to similarities.
The art of taxonomy requires that you actually separate that new thing that you think you found as much as you can from every other species that looks like it.
I like chocolate covered candy.
Okay.
And so we could group them together that way.
So essentially all of these on this side, and we can move the nerds over here.
And that one too?
Yep.
Yeah, can I have one of those?
Yes, feel free.
I think investigating their contents would be an important thing to look at.
All right.
It's not quite as hard as it looks.
Oh, wow.
That has some kind of jelly material in it. I don't usually use this test for specimens, but...
Do you eat the beetles that you study?
No, not normally. We occasionally sniff them, but that's all.
Oh.
Here are the roundish things, the big ones, and then the smaller roundish things would be more closely related to that batch here than it would be to any of the others.
Right now, I'm approaching these jars as collections made of what's likely the same species. The collections were made at one spot at one time.
You went to the river, put the jar in the water, and it was filled with Reese's Pieces.
Yeah, okay. In La La Land, I mean, but.
So we could group things together, put the chocolate ones together, mm-hmm. Or we could take all the red ones and put those together.
All of the red ones.
That would be like taking a whole bunch of different red birds and putting them all together because they're red, but one of them's a cardinal and one of them is some kind of duck, and, you know, they're not related
right.
at all.
They're not even close.
Yeah.
So would you put those with the other
bean shapes?
These
are bean-shaped here.
Okay.
And then you have the bean-shaped, you have the rounded that go closer, that go sort of with the bean shape. Then you have the small rounded that go closer with those.
So just flipping through these, I'm seeing these Reese's Pieces, different color. But the shape is amazingly uniform. These, with a strange letter M, have some damage. I see their guts are actually chocolate. So, and my hypothesis is that each of these things, despite being a different color, actually has guts of chocolate.
So you think that the red Skittles and the red Jolly Ranchers and the red black covered licorice, as gross as it is, can all be one thing?
Absolutely. That's the thing about candy. You can put it together, you can group them any way you want.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter.
The way they are mixed up, you can't classify them in colors because there is all colors and then one.
Right.
So, not many characters to go with.
I have insider knowledge. I've done extensive work on the taxonomy of jelly bellies. and I can tell you that there are 36 different flavors in here. What would you make of something like this?
It could be that if we worked out the taxonomy of these things, we might decide that the jelly bellies were a genus unto themselves, and those 36, 37 flavors were different species of jelly bellies.
Oh, wow.
Similarly, those other jelly bean things, mm-hmm. That would be another way to interpret those as well.
They're like distinct. In the same family.
Yeah.
In the jelly bean family.
The jelly bean family, right.
I want to organize candy in a way I can reach my hand in and shove them all in my face. You can't do that with the red candy, because then you got like the red peanut M&M and then the cinnamon jelly belly.
Cinnamon and peanut butter actually would go together well. We could try that.
I'm okay. I'm all right.
Get yourself out your pen and your paper or your computer and you say, why are they different? And you add all of those up, and then you go back and you look in the literature for previously published descriptions of things that are kind of like this, in the same genus, let's say, or maybe in related genera, because sometimes the genus isn't as good as you think it is.
Yeah.
And then you read those too, and you look at them, and if you're kind of confused, then you try and get a hold of specimens and that thing.
And then it keeps kind of going.
The goal of classification is just to bring out, in terms of organisms, to bring out their evolutionary relationships.
What makes organisms so different is that our classification of those is based on their relationships, on their ancestors. We don't put red bats and red foxes together. We could put red candy together, and it makes perfect sense, why not?
Right.
But we don't do it with red bats and red foxes because they don't share a common ancestor except way, 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 way back.
Yeah, there's very many ways to classify things, and it's an interesting problem. Why there should be so many ways to classify things and what these different classifications then say about the world.
And what does it say about us as people
for
choosing the ways that we choose?
Which means to say, is it us who brings order to the world, or is the world coming to us in an ordered way? And probably it's the first way around.
Oh, wow. Now you're going into the philosophical rabbit hole. It still has brains on it.